Hey, Lynette, Lynette.
Whoa. What is it, Tommy?
Guess what?
What?
I've been working on my ventriloquism.
Your ventriloquism, you say?
Yeah. Want to see?
Sure.
Okay. All right, check this out. Elephant sound. How's that?
I think you can do a little better.
Okay. Elephant sound. Was that better?
How about trying it without really moving your lips?
Okay. What do you think?
I think it could use a little bit of work.
I thought it was good.
It could use a bit of work.
Fine.
Now, shall we move along with the story?
Sure. What's this one about?
This one is about the Ascension and Pentecost. And we'll start with the Ascension.
Please do.
I will. So the Ascension, basically, it marked the end of Jesus' time on earth. Jesus spent 40 days after he rose from the dead telling his disciples about the kingdom of heaven. And he also told them about when he would return from heaven and restore the kingdom of Israel.
When's that going to happen?
Well, actually, one of the disciples asked that very question. And Jesus responded, "It is not for you to know the times or dates the Father has set by his own authority."
So we're not supposed to know that. Only God does?
Yeah, exactly.
Ah, I see.
Then after this, he told his disciples to be witnesses in Jerusalem and in Judea and Samaria and all around the world. And after that, the heavens opened up and he rose up into the clouds right before their eyes.
Oh my goodness.
I know. So following the Ascension comes Pentecost. This was when there was a gathering of many followers of Christ from all different nations in the area. And then suddenly there was a rush of violent wind and the Holy Spirit descended on them all and they all started speaking in different languages.
No way.
Yes way. So even though they were all from different places, they were still able to communicate with one another.
Well, how about that?
And what this shows is that God gives his people the Holy Spirit. And if we accept Jesus as our Savior, we too can have the Holy Spirit living within us.
But I've already got something living inside of me.
I see.
Yeah, it was a puppet joke.
Well, this is a little different than that. It's God's presence with you at all times. The Holy Spirit is a comforter and a helper, and that voice or feeling that guides us and reminds us of what God wants.
I think I get it.
Isn't that a great story?
I think so. What about you, Chantel? What do you think? Chantel?
She's on vacation.
What?
She's on vacation.
She gets vacations?
Yeah?
I don't get vacations.
Tell me, Tommy, when we're not filming, what do you do? Say again, I couldn't hear you.
I go to the beach.
That's exactly what I thought.
Still, the injustice. I'm going on strike.
Oh, Tommy, you've already tried this and it didn't work.
It still makes me feel better.
Whatever. Okay, here's a song for you called Holy Spirit.
There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. And I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, when my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord. And Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome. come by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord.
There's nothing.
There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. No thing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. And I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, when my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord. And Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness, Lord. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence.
Hi, kids. Now we're going to do the verse for this week. Len, tell them the verse.
Didn't you memorize it?
I memorized it. I just want you to say it.
All right. So today's verse is found in Acts chapter 2, verse 4. And it goes like this. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit. They began to speak in languages they had not known before. The Spirit gave them the ability to do this.
Wow. That's a wonderful verse, isn't it?
It is a wonderful mm-hmm. verse. Okay, so yep. I'm going to say a few words, and you're going to guess what language I'm saying them in, all right?
Oh, a game, I see.
A game.
Okay, all right, I'm really good at languages.
This okay.
fun, yeah.
First language, bonjour.
That's Spanish, right?
No, that's French. Okay.
You think?
Here's another way. Guten Tag.
Spanish, right?
No, that's Low German.
I could have sworn that was Spanish.
No.
I'm pretty sure it is.
Here's the next one.
Okay.
Konnichiwa.
Spanish?
Japanese.
Oh, I thought it was Spanish. Okay, next one.
Baño.
Is that Greek?
No, that was Spanish.
No, that was not Spanish. I know Spanish, okay? I know when I hear Spanish, and that was not Spanish.
Right. It's actually bathroom in Spanish.
No way.
Yeah!
No, it is not. It's Greek, I'm sure.
Wouldn't it have been amazing to be there on the day of Pentecost and be able to speak all kinds of languages, like whole languages, not just one word here or there, And to be able to understand whole languages. It would have just been amazing.
Yeah, I mean, that would have been really cool.
It would have been really cool. Let's read the verse together. Will you help me, Tommy, this time? I know you have it memorized, but if you want to help me read it.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll start with the address of where it's found, and then we'll say the verse, okay? Okay. Acts.
Chapter 2.
Verse 4. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit. They began to speak in languages they had not known before. The Spirit gave them the ability to do this. So good. Let's do it one more time, okay? Will you repeat after me again?
Yep, let's do it.
Okay. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit.
All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit.
They began to speak in languages they had not known before.
They began to speak in languages they had not known before.
The Spirit gave them the ability to do this.
The Spirit gave them the ability to do this.
So good. I forgot to do the address, though, of where it's found.
Oh, where is it found?
Acts chapter 2, verse 4.
Okay, I got it.
See if you can say that one on your own. Thanks for helping us out.
Lord, I come, I confess, bowing here, I find my rest. Without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord,
gracias for joining us. What stood out to you today? Did you learn anything new? I know I was reminded of God's power and how we have new life in Jesus. That's it for now. Au revoir.